a dance. Yeah. Oh, come on, the place. Yeah.
Amen.
let me get if I don't get you into this word, we ain't gonna make it. And that's gonna be all right too, because everything that's done and said is done and said in God. That started with the babies. Amen. I need you to turn your Bibles to Genesis 32. We bless you, God, for your spirit. We bless you, God, for your presence. We bless you, God, for your anointings. We bless you for the covering of the blood. We bless you for your covenant, God. We bless you because you are God and God alone. Oh, God. Father God, I pray even now, Father, that you will anoint me to give this word, Lord God, that you have proclaimed, God. Father, I pray you open up the ears of the people, God, that they might hear from you, not from me, but from you, God. I decrease that you may increase. I hide behind the cross, Lord, that I may not be revealed, but that you may be revealed, God. Less of me and more of you, God. Father, pour into me today that I might pour out to your people. Father, give me what I need to feed your sheep, God. Father, if you don't do it, it can't be done. Father, I need you to stand up in me now, that I might come forth before your people with a word of fire, with an anointed word, with a word from you, God. Now, Father, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And the church said, amen. I want you to turn to Genesis 32, and I'm going to start at the 22nd verse, and I will begin to read. And it reads, he rose up that night and took his two wives and his two women servants and his 11 sons and passed over the ford Jabbok. And he took them and sent them over the brook and sent over that they had. And Jacob was left alone. And there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And when he saw he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. Yes, yes. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go, except thou bless me.
All right.
Look to your neighbor and ask your neighbor, neighbor,
neighbor,
are you wrestling?
Are you wrestling?
Say, neighbor,
neighbor,
are you wrestling?
Are you wrestling?
Now, see, what we have here is the man called Jacob. Amen. Amen. Now, we know that Jacob was one that was rough even from the beginning. Yeah. Jacob had a brother called Esau. Yeah. Now, even from the beginning, these were twins, and they battled even from the womb. Amen. We know that Jacob was one that was always a trickster. Amen. Supplanter. When we say supplanter, we mean one of cunning means, yes. One of trickery, yes. One that's willing to get over on you if you allow it. Amen. Yes. Now, see, we know that Jacob was one that took his brother for granted more than one time. Mm-hmm. From birth, he wanted to be the first one out. Yes. His brother stuck his arm out and they put a band around it, but he pulled him back in.
Yes.
Come on now.
Right.
Come on, you know how it is. Somebody always got to get ahead of you when God says you next. Come on. I'm the delicate beat what God has already given victory to. We know the time goes on and we see the
say the twins are growing up, and here's Jacob on one side who takes on to his mother. Some would even call him a mama's boy. Amen. Oh, but that's all right too. Now, see, when we think about this, his mother taught him everything that she knew. How to cook and how to mend tapestry and to do the finer things. And where Esau was taught to get out in the field and be rough and, you know, you hunt and you do what a man does.
Yeah.
Well, we know that in the end, Jacob still wins. Esau comes in one day hungry and starving, ravenous, and he gives his birthright up for a bowl of soup.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. How many times has the devil caused us to give up our birthright for a good time? How many times has he caused us to give up our birthright for a one-night stand? How many times has the devil caused us to give up our birthright for one more shot? Oh, I messed up just one more time. Oh, come on now. I ain't the only one. But for that bowl of soup, he gave up his birthright. But you know, this is one thing that I understand is that when God has given you your birthright, God made a covenant with you. And in that covenant, he said, I don't care what you do, even though you don't, I will.
Amen.
I will. So let the devil try what he can't have what's already mine.
That's right.
Now as time goes on, we see that his father is even at the point of death. Comes in and his father can't see, and Jacob goes off and his mother tells him, here, I'm going to put this on you so your arms feel like your brother's arms and you smell like your brother. And when you go in, you tell your father to give you your portion.
Yeah.
He goes in and the father knows something ain't right, but he can't put enough together to say it ain't what I think it is.
Yes,
how many of you know that the devil wants you to think that it ain't what it look like? How many times has your good works been evil spoken of? How many times have you done right and I still say it wasn't enough? How many times have you been on the front line battling for all that it's worth and they still told you you didn't do enough? Somebody say something ain't right. Somebody say something ain't right. He blessed him.
Yes.
He gave away what was not his.
All
right. How many of you know that every time the devil gets an opportunity to take what ain't his, he gonna take it?
Right.
But see, what we got to realize today is that what God gave us, he meant for us to keep. And the only way the devil can get it is if we give it. Oh, I'm getting to a sermon because, see, my sermon talks about wrestling. All right. Y'all know I was a state championship wrestler. I was third in the nation. Amen. I was good at what I did. Amen. Now, see, Jacob knew and Esau came in to get his blessing, and all of a sudden his father say, I've given it all away. But then he said, well, look, look, Father, bless me also. Bless me as well. Come on now. You ever been in that point where you've been so down and out, and you see everybody around you, whether they stayed or not, here they come with a brand new car. They just got the promotion on the job. They house looking good right now. They stepping out in the finest arraignment.
Say that.
And you say, Lord, I'm your servant. Bless me too.
Yeah.
I'm deserving.
Bless me too.
But how many of you know the best is yet to come?
Come on now.
You ain't lived your best life yet. Your best life is still ahead of you. Your best life is waiting for you to catch up to it. See, because the devil was trying to hold you back here, he was trying to keep you from that goodness of the Lord. Oh, come on now. See, God knew it was going to happen. He said that I'll cause your blessings to overtake you. When you thought you missed your blessings, God said, you ain't missed out. You blessings, you don't have room enough to receive. Oh, somebody say, began to go away because he knew that if I stay here, my brother's surely going to kill me. Oh, come on now. How many of you that got tired of getting ran over? You got tired of them having their way with you. You got tired of them treating you like a doormat. And enough is enough. Somebody say, devil. So now I got your protection. I got to send you over here to your uncle's house. And when you get there, you tell him I sent you. And when he get there, he gonna look out for you. He gonna hide you. How many of you know God hides sometimes?
Oh,
come on now. We don't believe that. But we got away with it. that when you bless, even when you mess it up, God will still allow you to bless others. God won't fold because you're there. And you know you're doing some things that ain't right. But God said, I'm a whole other God. I got to bless you because I got to bless you. He don't deserve it, but my grace is sufficient.
Right mind, amen.
You remember what the prodigal son did? The prodigal son came to himself. And when he came to himself, he realized, I can't stand this mess that I'm in. I've been in this mess long enough, so now it's time for me to go get right.
Amen.
So he began to travel. With all he said, listen, if you slick, you just slick. He was so slick, he hoodwinked his uncle out of what was really his to start with. Uncle told him, he said, well, Lord, listen, you can keep all them that are blemished. So he started making cows so that one would come out with spots and this one would come out with hole and the other would have that spot. But how many of you know that when you cut a calf in half, the meat still just as good? Come on now. Hey. I take this over here where they ain't never seen it before. That'll be, you know what they call it? Exclusive.
Amen.
He got that exclusive. Come on now, that's what I used to tell them when I was selling drugs. I got that exclusive. Yeah, they got that power over there, but I got that exclusive. This will take you where they want. Guess where it came?